Pelo modo. So let me first start with the transfer part. H perpendicular is equal to minus sum over n m I n m. Since this operator is commute and I want to have operators normal ordered, I will write it as Sm minus Sm plus. Okay? Just for convenience. I can commute them here and rename n to m, and since my exchange integral depends on the modulus Rn minus Rm, I can always do it. So I start with this notation. So what I will do is to make a Fourier transform, sum over n m, I n m, 1 over m, which comes from sum over u1, u2, s minus u1 e to the power minus I u1 r m s plus u2 e to the power I u2 r m. Then I use this definition of the bosons and continue write it minus 1 over n sum over n m I n m sum over u1 u2 b dagger u1 b u2. I have to put square root over 2s twice, so therefore I write 2s in front of this expression, and what remains is exponent e to the power minus I u1 Rm plus I u2 Rm. Okay, you see that I keep it just, I don't need it, but still, in order to see that we don't make a mistake, sometimes it's better. Look, but please don't memorize anything. Everything can be derived. Therefore, any note is just for logical structure of the talk, but don't be so much involved in following notes. One needs to follow the logics. Okay, here we recall that I and M depends on modulus Rn minus Rm. And therefore, if we denote Rn equal to rho plus Rm, as we did before, and change summation over n and m, so this is minus 2s over n, summation over m and rho, we have I depending on rho, sum over q1, q2, b dagger q1, b q2 e to the power I r m q2 minus u1 minus I u1 rho. So what depends on m? Only the argument of this exponent. Sum over m e to the power I q2 minus q1 rm is equal to m delta function q1 q2. So m is cancelled and what remains minus 2s. I use the fact that there is a delta function and change notation, replace q1 and q2 both being equal to q, and there is only one summation over q. Here it's b dagger q dq, and what remains, summation over rho, I rho e to the power minus I q rho. So this is what we call the structure factor and what is equal to I q. I put it here. I don't need to convince you about notations at all, that h perpendicular is very simple. It's equal to minus 2s sum over q I q b w q b q. Very simple quadratic notation. I only achieved diagonalization of this Hamiltonian, namely perpendicular part of it. And now I want to proceed with a longitudinal one. Questions? If not, then I will keep this Fourier rules, because these rules tell me the convention. And what I'm going to do now, and let me put it with quotation mark, is to calculate longitudinal part, sum over n, m, I, n, m, s, n, z, s, m, z. But you see, none of this operator can be directly expressed in terms of b. Therefore, I have to do something. And in order to do something, let me recall that s square is equal to s plus 1. I'm informed to my colleagues, the square of operator is equal to this. On each side n, where s is a maximum value of projection. On one hand it is like that, on another hand it's of course 1 half s n plus s n minus plus s n minus s n plus plus s n z square. Now it's good, because I can work with s n z. Here I need to massage it a little bit in order to have expressions in terms of b operators, and as a result, subtracting square root, I will derive an expression which connects me as a z and b and b w. This is the logic. And let me proceed with that. In order to do it, I will take a Fourier transform. So it's 1 half, 1 over n, sum over q1, q2, s plus n is equal to s q plus 1 e to the power I q1 r n times s q2 minus e to the power minus I q2 r n plus s q 1 minus, doesn't matter, e to the power minus I, maybe I write q2, q2 r n s q 1 plus e to the power I q 1 r n plus s m z square. So already something. It is written to, it is equal to 1 half, 1 over n. I substitute expressions in terms of b and b dagger operator. I have 2s here, sum over q1, q2, b q1, b dagger q2, plus b dagger q2, b q1, times e to the power I of L 1 minus 2 plus SMV square. Now, in this sum, I can express the second term in terms of commutator. Therefore, I will have it, namely, not the second, but the first one. It is equal to, I continue it here, S over N, sum over Q1, Q2, and I write as the first term as B dagger Q2 BQ1 plus delta function Q1 Q2 plus the second term, which doubles me this one, e to the power I Rn Q1 minus Q2 plus Sn square. So the integral with delta function Q1 is equal to Q2 gives me the number of spins, so it is equal to S, right, plus 2S over N, sum over Q1, Q2, B dagger Q2, B Q1, e to the power I Q1 minus Q2, R N, plus S N Z square. Okay, good. The left-hand side of my equation tells me that this is equal to S times S plus 1, so this is S squared plus S. Therefore, SNZ is equal to square root. Making left and right-hand side equal, I have square root over S squared plus minus, I have to subtract this, 2s over n, sum over q1, q2, b dagger q2, b q1, e to the power I q1 minus q2, rn. Or, if I put aside S, it's square root 1 minus 2 over S N, right? Sum over Q1, Q2, B dagger Q2, B Q1, e to the power of I, Q1 minus Q2, R N. So far so good. The expression is still exact. But I cannot work with this nonlinear radical anymore, so what I would like to do is to do approximation. And in order to do approximation, I say, suppose that my spin is large. So S is a big number. Therefore, the term in the radical, the second one, is much smaller compared to the first one. So I can expand. 1 over square root 1 minus x is approximately equal to 1 minus x squared. So I will continue here, saying that in approximation s much larger than 1, I have s times 1 minus 1 over sn, sum over q1, q2, b dagger q2, b q1, e to the power I Q1 minus Q2, Rn. You see that the first term gives me S, and the second term is what I wanted to get. So now, I know how operators S, N, Z are connected to the bosonic variables. So therefore, longitudinal part of the Hamiltonian, which is minus sum over N, N, I, N, N, S, N, Z, S, N, Z, is equal to minus sum over N, M, I, N, M. I have S minus 1 over M, sum over U1, U2. B value of U2, B, U1, e to the power I, U1 minus U2, R, N, times S minus 1 over N, sum over Q3, U4, B value of U4, B, U3, e to the power I, U3 minus U4, R, N. Here, it's only approximation, because what I dropped in the square root, I dropped quadratic in terms of B operator's term. Therefore, when I open the bracket, I will need to keep only, I dropped quadratic term, namely the term which contains B dagger B, B dagger B. Therefore, when I open this bracket, being in the same approximation, I should not keep the term which is product of this one. It is of the same smallness which was disregarded when I approximate my square root by this expression. So, I only took three terms in the bracket, and I have minus sum over n, m, I, n, m. First term, s squared, gives me a constant. Second term is minus s over n, and there are two terms of that sort, sum over q1, q2, b dagger q2, b q1, e to the power I q1 minus q2 r n. That's all. So let's look at first one. It's a constant. So it's a minus s square. If I say that I'm in the model described by interaction of only nearest neighbors, and this coupling constant is equal to I, then I have I times number of sides times coordination number. And times S squared. So what remains there? Minus and minus give me plus 2s over n, sum over n, m, I, n, m, sum over q1, u2, b dagger u2, b, q1, e to the power I, q1 minus q2, r, n. In this summation, it's clear that I come to summation over rho and n, therefore I will write here n and rho. I depends on rho, bless you, depends on rho, and only exponent depends on m. N, using the same property that this is n times delta function, I continue it here. What we get is minus s square I n z plus 2s. Here, as I said, there is a delta function. Q1 is equal to 2, q2. So this is sum over q, b dagger q, bq. And then there is a sum over rho, I rho. But this is nothing but z times I. Okay? So I collect both terms. I'm done with my calculations. I don't need anything for Jevons for convention. I just need to collect two terms. So my Hamiltonian H, which is equal to H parallel plus H perpendicular, is equal to, first of all, constant, minus S square I M Z plus 2S sum over Q B dagger U B Q. And here, as I said, I have I Q equal to 0 from the longitudinal term minus I Q. So this is clearly the ground state energy, and this is energy of excitations. So my energy, ground state, is equal to minus S squared I N times Z. And here, let me write it down as H prime is equal to 2 times S. I will take I out and Z. And here I have sum of Q 1 minus 1 over Z sum over rho e to the power I U rho B divers U VQ. So this was the structure factor, which last time I denoted as phi Q. And for simple cubic lattice, we calculated it. So phi Q for simple cubic lattice is equal to 1 over 6, since coordination number is 6, so it's simple cubic. Don't confuse it with superconducting. And here it's cosine U x a plus cosine u y a plus cosine u z a. Twice. So it is 1/3 times cosine. So let's now look at the dispersion of excitations. What we have done, we diagonalized our Hamiltonian, we presented it in terms of non-interacting oscillators. Of course, we disregard all effects of interaction by first approximating the square root by the linear term, and second, dropping the terms quadratic in DZ interaction. But having done that, let's look at this expression for small q. We have already studied last time, so approximately for qa much smaller than 1, we have 1/3, and here it's 1 times 3, therefore it's 3, each cosine gives me 1, minus q squared a squared over 2. So it's approximately, it's equal to 1 minus qa squared over 6. This is what we obtained for our Arnstein-Zernike theorem. Therefore, h prime is equal to 2s I times 6 for simple cubic lattice. Here is sum of q. 1 minus 1 gives me 0, and we have a plus q squared a squared over 6 b dagger q b q. So in principle, we write it as sum over q lambda q squared b dagger q b q, where lambda is equal to 2 times s I a square. So what we obtain that we do have gapless excitations. So in order to excite this magnum for spin density wave for very small q requires very small energy, there is no gap, and the dispersion epsilon q, the function of q, is quadratic. Epsilon q, the function of q, is lambda q squared. Lambda sometimes is called stiffness, and but you see that this dispersion is pretty similar to free bosons. Free bosons means no interactions. Okay, so that's what is our main result for today's lecture. And I probably stop here because the day after tomorrow we do a little bit more complicated transformations, including QE transformation, which we already know from theory of weakly interacting with the gas, to diagonalize the Hamiltonian subject to two sublattices, namely where I is negative. We see what kind of dispersion law exists for that system. Then we compare thermodynamical properties of the magnums described by quadratic and another dispersion law, and we discuss how Lagrange order can be established in low dimensional systems and why fluctuations prevent Lagrange order in low dimensional systems. Okay, but you see the calculations are very simple and the result is very remarkable. Question?
So, this excitation energy is quadratic, right?
Sorry?
This excitation energy is quadratic, right?
Of course. We have non-interacting modes, we have non-interacting oscillators, and each oscillator, and this is H omega, depends on q, you have a propagation of waves. So your wave equation, which is omega minus epsilon q square, in some sense gives you dispersion. Omega is equal to plus minus epsilon q. So this is a wave propagating in the right or left direction, and the dependence of wave vector at small momentum are given by this relation. In principle, we obtain this dependence for all wave momentum, and this quadratic dependence is only at long wave limit, at large distances. So this is how collective modes propagate. So why are we interested in the small q behavior? Because we want to know the behavior on the large scales. This is what we do in so-called hydrodynamical approach. Okay? Then to the day after tomorrow, we continue with antiferromagnets, we see the difference, and we will draw some conclusions from this exercise.